You're watching the free version of Mocha Essentials. Follow along with projects and footage with a premium download available at borisfx.com.
Hi, I'm Mary Poppin with BorisFX, and we're going to talk about adjusting your track. Mocha is an excellent planar tracker, but sometimes there's going to be shots that look like this. We're going to talk about this shot in another lesson, which is called When It All Goes Wrong, and you're going to see what I mean. If we want to track something like this crosswalk or these plates on the ground, we don't have a lot of area of ground that is uncontaminated to track here. The further we get to the edges of the screen, the more likely we're going to encounter problems with our track due to things like lens curvature or road curvature. So we need to track as close to the area that we're trying to track as possible. So what that means for this shot is it leaves us this tiny little sliver of road to track with texture on it that isn't contaminated by headlights, walking figures, shadows, occlusions, or buses running right over the top of them. So we've put our surface tool right here on our crosswalk, and we're tracking as close to that area as we can. The best way to fix your tracking data in the first place is to find the fundamental cause of the tracking error. On this shot, that's just not possible, and you're going to encounter these problems on all sorts of real-world shots. Now, there's times you shouldn't be using AdjustTrack. When you need to manually get around an object, you can use manual track for that in many cases. Sometimes AdjustTrack can be helpful. If your track is extremely bad, you should not be using AdjustTrack. You really only want to use AdjustTrack on shots where there's a little bit of drift. If your track is extremely bad, you need to go back and use a combination of better tracking techniques and manual track to get a much smoother track. So in order to adjust track, let's go to the end of our frame where we have aligned our surface really nicely to the ground plane. I want to make sure that my four corners are exactly where they're supposed to be. And we're going to jump over to the Adjust Track tab. In the Adjust Track tab, we have the ability to create all sorts of tracking compensation. We can track for translation only, which will set one point. The nice thing about one point is it allows you to move the surface tool wherever you like in an X and Y fashion. We can use scale and rotation. This option will allow you to alter the track based on scale and rotation and the difference between two corrective points. We can also use shear, which is 3 points, and allows us to skew in X and Y space. And of course, we can use perspective for a 4-point corner correction, just like this. For this shot, we're going to want to use perspective. So we're going to hit Reset All to reset all of our points. And we're going to set all 4 of our points. We can select our points and set this last frame as our reference frame. So this is the last place where our surface tool looks good. You can see up here in our thumbnail view, we have our reference frame. And if we select our points, it'll show us the reference frame for all 4 of our points as we cycle between them. What I like to do is move all the way to the end of the shot and then make a correction based on my previous and current frame. Now I know that this corner goes here, this one goes here, this goes here, and this goes here. But the nice thing is Mocha can actually try to auto-adjust for us based on our original frame. And that means Mocha will try to match the reference frame to our current frame. Now we can start to see where the track goes off again. I'm looking for those arcs of the animation where the tracking is the most incorrect. And again, we're going to auto. I'll see if this will auto, but it might not. It does. Auto. We're going to manually move this one and auto this one. Now those look pretty good, but let's look for any other major disturbances in our track. Like that one's pretty bad, so let's hit auto again. All right, now let's turn our thumbnails off and zoom out. Back in our track tab, let's hit play. This is a pretty jittery shot with a lot of camera shake, but I'm pretty happy with how that track looks now. And now I can take this tracking data and use it however I like, whether that be attaching text to the shot, patching objects on the ground, or trying to stabilize this shot. Another cool feature is the surface view, where you can click between the four corners of the surface that you have positioned. And when in the surface view, you can adjust your points the same way you would with your corners, but you can see what the actual edge of the surface is doing. So this is a really handy tool, especially if your four points aren't aligned exactly at the corners of your surface tool. It can be really helpful to see if everything is still aligning. We also have a tool called Auto Step, and Auto Step will actually try to jump between every couple of frames that you define and try to do an adjust track at an interval that you choose, like 10 pixels, for example. You don't want this number to be too low. If this number is too low, you can get jittery results. AutoStep has now tried to guess every 10 frames what its adjustment should be. On shots where the points are really obvious, AutoStep can be a really great solution. But anytime you have lighting occlusions and other occlusions, it can get dicey. So for really easy adjust tracks, it can be an absolutely cheat-worthy magic bullet. But for most shots, you're still going to need to do corrections by hand. All right, so we talked about identifying the problem with your track and when to adjust it. We talked about setting adjust track points, setting a reference frame in adjust track, and then adjusting them. We talked about using the surface view and whether or not you need to use auto step and when. In our next video, lesson 2, exercise 7, we're going to talk about what to do when it all goes wrong.
You've been watching the free version of Mocha Essentials. To download all videos, projects, and footage, purchase the premium version available at borisfx.com.